Use these part drawings to build the part shown in SOLIDWORKS. Unit system inches, part origin Z-axis, material nickel silver 6512. This is the second example for the Revolve and Patterns main video. The links to that video, the first example and other lectures are found in the description below. Since the section view is coming from the right, recreate a sketch on the right plane, and after placing a center line at the bottom and replicating the overall geometry of the cross-section, without including the holes that will clearly be added later as part of a circular pattern on the front face, we dimension all the features that we are being given, including the radii information found in the front view. Just like in the previous examples, we use this sketch to revolve it, and since we created that horizontal center line, SOLIDWORKS will automatically use it as an axis of revolution. On the front face, we create an extruded cut with a sketch of the top straight slot, 0.75 for its center line, starting at 0.50 plus 0.35 inches away from the center, and 0.12 for its radius. This cut is through all. We now select it to go to circular pattern, select the inner circle for direction 1, type 8 for the number of instances, since these slots are 45 degrees apart, and under instances to skip, we select the left and right instances. And finally, for the circular holes in the radial direction, we can just create an extruded cut on the top plane and use the dimensions found in the top view to create a circle that is centered with the origin. We make this hole go from that plane going all the way to the bottom, meaning through all, and we circular pattern it with 8 instances around the inner circle. To finish this, we add a 0.1 inches fillet and assign it at nickel silver 6512 material. The links to more CSWA type examples as well as the main 10-minute lectures of the SOLIDWORKS course and other engineering courses are found in the description below, so make sure to check them out. Thanks for watching!